Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In the last video, I gave you an overview of Jetpack Compose. And from this video, we will start learning about Jetpack Compose in our Android Studio project. So let's start a new Android project and let's see how we can use Jetpack Compose to design our Android UIs. But before starting, you have to make sure that you are using the latest Android Studio version. And you have to use this Arctic Fox version of Android Studio. So just go to the website and download the latest Android Studio, or you can just update your existing Android Studio. So once you have your Android Studio updated, you need to go to this option, that is New Project. I will tell you how you can use Jetpack Compose in your existing project later on. But first, we will start a new project. So from here, we will select phone and tablet because we want to create an application for phone or tablet. And we will select empty compose activity. So here you can see we have this new template, that is empty compose activity. So if you want to use Jetpack Compose for your projects, then you can use this template and everything will be set up automatically if you use this template for creating your Android project. So I will select this option and then next. Now I will give any name, let's say Jetpack Compose Introduction or whatever you want. And everything else is fine. We will just finish to create the project. So once your project is successfully loaded, you will see something like this. And here you can see we have our default package. And we have one new package inside the default package, that is UI.theme. And this time, no more XMLs and everything will be inside Kotlin files only. So you can see we have color, shape, theme, type. We will get onto these later. But for now, let's come inside this main activity. So this is our main activity class. And here you can see we are using the function setContent. Previously, we were using setContentView function to set an XML layout file to our activity. But this time, we are using this setContent function because we are working with Jetpack Compose. And inside this function or to this function, we are passing a trailing lambda as an argument. So I hope you know the basics of Kotlin and you understand what is a trailing lambda. It is basically an argument that we are passing to the setContent function. If we control click this function, then you can see this function accepts a parent and we have a default value for the parent. That is why it is optional to pass it. And the next parameter is a composable and it is a function as you can see here. And that is why we are passing a trailing lambda here. That means we can pass a composable function to this setContent function. And a composable function is a function that is annotated with @composable. For example, we have this Jetpack Compose Introduction theme. We are passing this function to this setContent function. If I control click here, then you can see this is a composable function. But for now, I will delete everything. So I will delete everything from here. And here you can see we have two functions. The first function is greeting, that is a composable function. So if you want to create a composable function, you need to annotate your function with this @composable annotation. And then you can create a function. Your function can accept any number of arguments. And inside your composable function, you can use other composables. For example, here we are using text. If we control click this text, then you can see this text is a composable function. You can see we have this text and it is nothing but a composable function. And it is equivalent to text view that we were using with Android XMLs. So if you want to create a text label or you want to create a text view in Jetpack Compose, you need to use this text function that is predefined. So we have a bunch of predefined composable functions for text views, image views, buttons, etc. that we were using with Android XML layouts. And for those UI components, we have some equivalent composable functions. And one example is this text that we will use in place of text view. So here we have created our custom composable function, and inside that custom composable function, we are using a predefined composable function. And the naming convention for a composable function is, we will start the word with a capital letter. Usually we write our function names with a small letter, as you can see here, but these are composable functions. And the naming convention is to start it with a capital letter. But it is not necessary that you should follow the naming conventions, but it is always a good idea to follow the naming conventions. If you change the name and make it a small g, it will not make any difference in the output, but you should follow the naming conventions. So this is the composable function greeting, and inside this we are using one more predefined or existing composable function, text, that we use to display a simple text in the UI. Now you can easily preview your composable functions, and as you can see, we are getting a preview here. So you can see here our code editor is splitted as we had with Android XMLs. Now we have code mode, we have split mode, and we have design mode. So we will be inside this mode to write the code and see the result. So to see the preview, you need to create one more function, and you need to annotate this function with @preview, and then only you can see the preview. So this preview is also a composable function. As you can see here, we have @composable, and then we have a function default preview. You can give any name, it doesn't matter. And inside the default preview function, we have another predefined composable function, that is Jetpack Compose Introduction Theme, and it accepts a trailing lambda. And inside the lambda, we are calling our custom composable function, that is greeting, and we are passing the name that we want to display. If I change the name to my name, let's say Bilal Khan, and you can see we are getting the default preview. So this is hello Bilal Khan. So this is how we write composable functions. You have to use @composable, and if you want to preview, you need to use this annotation, that is @preview. This flag means we will see the background. Now you can see we have a very small, you know, UI area here, but if you will run the application, you will see your full screen. And currently, if you will run the application, you will not see anything because we have removed the setContent function, and that function sets the UI to your activity. So if you want to see the output to your emulator, what you need to do is you need to call the function again. Let's say we will call setContent that accepts a trailing lambda. So we will use this function, that is setContent. And here we will pass a composable function. For now, I will pass greeting. So I can pass greeting, and let's say I will pass my name only, or you can pass anything. And if I run the application now, I will see this text in my output. So let's run the application. As you can see, we are getting the output, that is hello Bilal Khan. So this is how you can create your first project using Jetpack Compose. For now, let's try something else. So you can see here we are getting a very small output. So I want to make it to fill the maximum height and fill the maximum width. So what you can do is you can use one more container. If you remember the XML way, then what we do is we create a linear layout or constraint layout, and inside that layout we put all our child components. So the constraint layout or linear layout, whatever you are using, acts as a container to contain all the child components. And the same way, we can use surface with Jetpack Compose. So inside my greeting function, what I will do is I will create a surface. So you can see we have surface, and we just need to write surface like this. So we have the surface. It again accepts a trailing lambda, and inside the lambda I will put the text like this. And for a parameter, I will pass a modifier. So here I can write modifier like this. So you can also use named arguments. So we have modifier equals to modifier, then dot, I will write fill max height, and then again I will call fill max width. So it is like match parent and match parent for the width and the height. So if I preview this composable, so here you can see we have our preview function. Now this time we have created a surface, and inside that surface we have our text. So if we want to preview this function, then it is already added to our preview function. So we just need to build and refresh, and we will see our preview. So you can see this time we have a big preview because we have added a modifier. So we can chain it. So we can write modifier, and we can call as many functions as we want. And we will learn about more modifiers as we move ahead in this course. For now, this is for match parent and match parent, if you want to compare it with XML. And if you do not want to call two functions, then you can simply call one function, that is fill max size. It means width and height both to maximum. Again, match parent, match parent. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. So please give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and you can share this video with all your friends who are learning Android application development. And in case you have any problem or confusion, you can leave your comments below. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.